A juror was dismissed this morning in the McDonald's corruption trial. After that, it was pretty much business as usual in the Richmond courtroom, until there was talk of cookies and director Steven Spielberg. Northern Virginia Bureau Chief Jeff Goldberg is live once again in Richmond. He's got the latest for us on today's developments. Jeff, fill us in.
Another interesting day here in Richmond, Leon. About that juror who was dismissed, we never got a reason as to why that happened, but we can tell you that he is no longer on the jury. An alternate has been moved up to the jury, and now we are down to two alternates. We heard testimony this afternoon from an investigator with the Virginia State Police who says that after the investigation into the McDonald's began, he asked a member of the governor's executive protection unit to get information and whereabouts on the first couple, and he did. But that agent testifying today, he never asked that member to listen in on phone calls, eavesdrop, or read emails. The origins of the charges against the McDonald's came into clearer focus today as Special Agent Charles Hagan of the Virginia State Police testified it all started with the check written by Johnny Williams for the catering bill for Kaylin McDonald's wedding. Authorities only discovered it after investigating allegations of stolen food at the governor's mansion by the house chef who also catered the wedding. While looking into Williams for possible securities fraud, Agent Hagan testified they also discovered the $50,000 check he wrote to the McDonald's. It appeared there might be some illegality by the governor, Hagan said. Hagan and another agent met with Maureen McDonald at the mansion in February 2013 about the stolen food. She was very pleasant at first, Hagan says, but got more inquisitive as agents asked about Williams.
I'm thrilled it's over and it'll be up to the jury now.
Testimony also wrapped by former Virginia Attorney General and star scientific lobbyist Jerry Kilgore, who said he was the one who advised Johnny Williams to seek state funding and help through the Tobacco Commission, UVA, and VCU.
You know, I said it on the stand, he believed he had the support of the First Lady and the governor.
And VCU cardiologist George Vetrovic, who was considering working with Star Scientific on Anatoblock, says Williams invited him to the governor's mansion in early 2012 for some really good cookies baked by the First Lady. But once